The international reach of modern organized crime was again the primary focus in episode 2 of BBC One's thriller, McMafia, which is based on Misha Glenny's scarily percipient book, following a blood-soaked opening episode that saw wealthy banker Alex Godman, James Norton, struggling to resolve the clash between his comfortable, civilized English upbringing and his Russian family's violent past. Events moved on apace as he became drawn still further into the shadowlands between criminality and high finance. The episode opened in yet another foreign location, Egypt, where Ludmila Nikolaevna, Sofia Lebedeva, an innocent-looking Russian 22-year-old, was arriving at Cairo Airport to take up a job as a beauty therapist. But the job offer was a scam. Almost immediately Ludmila was kidnapped and, over a series of short, disturbingly brutal scenes, sold on as a worker/slave via a long chain of violent criminals. Credit, BBC. This was just one strand in an episode where Alex's principal storyline played out against a skilfully orchestrated series of subplots. Regarding his shadowy new Israeli investor Semyon Kleiman's, David Strathairn, efforts to expand his underworld business interests in Europe and Asia. This with the aim, allegedly, of undermining Russian mafia kingpin Vadim Kalyajin, Mirab Ninitz, the man threatening Alex's family. It was all ferociously complicated, flitting from London to Moscow, Cairo to Prague and on to Mumbai via the Cayman Islands, Dubai and the Negev Desert. Credit, BBC. Yet it remained involving and remarkably unconfused for the most part, thanks to the assured writing of Hossein Amini and James Watkins, and Watkins's pacey, pin-sharp direction. That's not to say that some of the action wasn't just a little hard to believe. Most of all, the unlikely ease with which Kleiman lured the determinedly hands-off, supposedly very intelligent Alex into a meeting in Prague with a patently dodgy Czech gangster. Not alone that, but Alex took to his uninvited role as Kleiman's consigliere with even more unlikely gusto. Still, it worked well enough to keep us thoroughly engaged, largely thanks to Norton's admirably cryptic performance, which makes it all but impossible to read whether Alex is an innocent with a terrific poker face or a born criminal mastermind with the ice-cold heart of a killer. The key to that mystery lies, surely, in Alex's family background and, especially, his broken, embittered father, Dmitry Alexei Serebryakov. How did this wreck of a man propel his family to such wealth that, even with most of it stolen by Kalyajin, the family could still live like kings in exile in London? Dmitry's failed suicide attempt toward the episode's end may yet provide the answer to that riddle. As for Ludmila, her turning up at Kleiman's mansion in Israel at the close seemed a rather convoluted turn of events. But, like so much else in this drama, it was also irresistibly intriguing. McMafia remains decidedly more